highly pathogenic avian influenza outbreak has become the largest animal health emergency in U.S. history. Mass mortality composting was implemented on the majority of infected poultry operations during the recent avian influenza outbreaks. Composting is the controlled biological decomposition process that converts organic matter into a stable, humus-like product and generates temperatures adequate to destroy most pathogens, including the avian influenza virus. Essentially, large windrows are formed by surrounding poultry carcasses and manure with carbon materials such as wood chips, wood shavings, corn stover, or other available carbon. Following windrow construction, temperatures are monitored daily using a long-stem thermometer. After windrow evaluation and approval of the temperature data collected during the initial 14-day compost cycle, the compost is ready for turning. The purpose of turning the windrow is to provide homogenization of the core, base, and cap materials, while exposing the microorganisms to additional oxygen through pile aeration. During windrow turning, other factors such as compost moisture content can be observed and corrected if needed. The turning process results in increased microbial activity, a rise in pile temperature, and accelerated carcass degradation. There are several different options available depending on the location of the windrow. A space of at least 25 feet in length should be left open at the end of the poultry house. Using skid loaders with high-capacity buckets, work in tandem from each side of the windrow, moving material to the open area at the end of the house. When turning compost, cascade material from the loader to provide for proper mixing and aeration. Windrows must maintain adequate porosity and structure after turning. A space of at least 25 feet in length should be left open at the end of the poultry house. Starting at the end of the windrow, scoop up all compost, turn the machine around, and drop the mixture forming a new windrow. Again, the material needs to be turned in a manner that provides maximum aeration.
We have to remember that in the process where you get air through the bottom, so it's important when you're turning whatever you're using not to actually run along the edge of the pile, so you're compressing the edge of the pile so you can still continue to get the airflow into the pile.
Use a small dozer to push or roll over windrows. This method requires building the original windrow off-center to allow space to turn the pile. A skilled operator is necessary to avoid damaging the equipment and building. This procedure is only feasible in larger houses with open space and high ceilings. Larger equipment can be utilized outdoors due to increased space. Articulated loaders, or dozers, move larger amounts of compost material more efficiently than skid loaders. As with in-house windrow turning, the newly formed windrow must maintain adequate structure for proper airflow. Material should be turned in a manner to allow for proper mixing and aeration. Mechanical compost turners can be used to thoroughly mix compost windrows. These may include tractor-attached turners or straddle-type turners. In either case, windrows should be spaced far enough apart to allow the tractor and turner to operate. Large units are required when turning 12 to 15-foot wide windrows.
If you're going to use a mechanical turner, such as a TMR wagon or a mechanical pull-behind or a straddle turner, there's some mechanical advantages to that. One is that you will get some particle reduction and breaking up clumps within the pile so that you get, again, a more homogenized material into the pile, and that you get air throughout the pile and you get less anaerobic pockets in those piles. So it's the the TMR wagon is usually some type of auger system that's breaking up. In a tag-along or a straddle, you have teeth. And the nice thing about the tag-alongs is that they also form a nice parabolic windrow system so that you get the formation of the windrow that you want for good airflow and good decomposition process.
Turning windrows allows for thorough mixing of the carbon material, carcasses, and manure, and promotes a more ideal blend of carbon and nitrogen for optimum composting. Turning should occur after the initial 14-day compost cycle, in which soft tissue decomposition has taken place. Windrows should only be turned after proper evaluation of temperature data by a subject matter expert. If soft tissue is observed on the windrow surface after turning, additional carbon material should be applied as a cap. Following established protocols for turning compost windrows results in increased microbial activity, temperatures, and carcass degradation during the second 14-day compost cycle.